Numbers with infinite significant figures. Sometimes you will come across a number that looks as if it is written with a small number of significant figures, but it actually has an infinite number of them. These numbers are called either exact numbers or exact definitions. There are two parts to this video. First, recognizing exact numbers and exact definitions. Second, I am going to be doing a unit conversion example problem involving an exact definition. Just because some of the numbers in your calculation have an infinite number of significant figures does not let you off the hook for determining how many significant figures should be in a calculated answer. I want to teach you how to recognize when you are dealing with exact numbers and exact definitions, and I'm going to show you what your teacher or professor might do to give you a major hint that you are dealing with infinite significant figures. So exact numbers come from counting indivisible things. For example, there are 6 people in a closed room. I really, really hope that this number 6 is an exact number. If you actually have 6.2 people in a closed room, you have a major problem on your hands, and that is probably the direction that the problem is going in. Another example, 12 molecules of butane. Butane has a molecular formula of C4H10. Let's look at a molecular model. This model of butane, you can see 4 black carbon atoms and 10 yellow hydrogen atoms. If I break this molecule in half and look at just one half, this is not half of a molecule of butane. Butane is C4H10. This is C2H5. This is something else entirely. This would be a chemical reaction that resulted in the formation of something else. So the opposite of counting would be measuring. If you are using instrumentation to measure something, those measurements do have a certain specific number of significant figures. So if you are using a ruler to measure a length, or you are using a graduated cylinder to measure a volume, those measurements have a certain specific number of significant figures depending on the precision of the instrumentation you've used. I do have another video on that topic, determining how many significant figures should be in a measurement, but these are opposite concepts. Counting indivisible things has an infinite number of significant figures. Another case when you have infinite significant figures is exact definitions. For example, metric prefixes. The definition of a metric prefix is that it has an infinite number of significant figures. So kilo is exactly 1,000 times greater. So if I am using the information that 1 kilometer equals 1,000 meters to convert between units, those two numbers can be treated as if they have infinite significant figures. And finally, this sentence at the bottom. This is going to come in helpful. The mass of 1 mole of carbon-12 atoms is exactly 12 grams. If your teacher or your professor is trying to give you a major hint that you are dealing with infinite significant figures, look for words like exactly or exact somewhere in the wording of the problem. That is going to be your hint. Let's do a unit conversion example problem involving an exact definition. But first, I am assuming that you already know how to look at numbers and determine how many significant figures are in them, and I am assuming that you know how to round a calculated number after multiplication and division. If you do not already know those two things, please watch my other videos in this playlist on those two topics first. But this problem is, convert 3,280 meters into units of kilometers, given 1 kilometer equals 1,000 meters. I have the mathematical calculation written out here, and I have the answer that a calculator would give. We need to figure out how to round this answer. But 3,280 meters times 1 kilometer divided by 1,000 meters equals 3.28 kilometers. So the rules for significant figures in multiplication and division is that we need to figure out how many significant figures are in all of the starting numbers. We take whichever one has the fewest number of significant figures, That is how many significant figures should be in the answer. So we have to determine how many significant figures are in each of these numbers first. 3,280 is written with three significant figures. 1 kilometer and 1,000 meters. These two numbers look like they are written with one significant figure, but we are dealing with exact definitions here. This is what this video is about. Even though these look like they have one significant figure, they each have an infinite number of significant figures, because 1 kilometer equals exactly 1,000 meters. So the three digits we are comparing, 3, infinite, infinite, the lowest of these numbers is the 3. The answer needs to be rounded to 3 significant figures. In this case, it already has 3 significant figures, so 3.28 kilometers is the correct answer. If you didn't realize that these two numbers were an exact definition, and you assumed they only had one significant figure, you would have rounded this answer to one significant figure. You would have gotten an answer of 3 kilometers. That would have been wrong. You would have gotten the incorrect answer in a problem like this if you did not realize that this was an exact definition with infinite significant figures. Thanks for watching Chemistry in a Nutshell. If you feel that I've earned it, please like this video and subscribe to my channel.